Hi everybody, welcome back. So I'm just going to have a little summary, do a little summary on what we've covered so far. It's really important to keep going over, going through some of the stuff that we've covered. So we in the very first video, we had a look at Java and the Java virtual machine. Comments that are done with these slashes here. I can actually move them up to the next line and they'll still be commented out in the color green. These are known as end of line comments and they begin with the two slashes. The other comments that are done that are already part of the Java documentation are done with these slash and two stars, so they're delimited by these, which enable you to embed program documentation in your code and that kind of thing. And they can also, in other different integrated development environments, they can also be integrated automatically. So it depends on what your method, which is here, your method here, it will automatically put in the parameters up here in your Java documentation, which is really cool. By convention, all class names begin with a capital letter, so I keep reiterating that. That's really important. It's a public class declaration that must be saved in the file with the same name. So if you see here, this is called Hello World, and this is also called Hello World.java. That's really important. Methods perform tasks and return information. And so with this, they have a keyword. This keyword here with this method is void, and that means that it doesn't return anything. So if we wanted to return something, then we'd put something else here, so such as int or string, and that would return an integer or a string based on what it does in the method here. You can compile the program using the command line for it. So let's say, for instance, using Java C as your command, but we're using the integrated development environment and it already automatically does it for you. So over here, we've got system.out.print. We use also system.out.printf, and the F means that it's formatted. So it's already formatted in data that you can see. The formatted specifiers begin with the percentage sign and then followed by a character. So for instance, percentage S is the placeholder for a string, percentage N is for a line separator, percentage D is for an integer, and percentage F is floating point, or used for double or floats. We use an import. We import this into our code, and that's a predefined classes or groups or packages is what they're officially called, into our code. And the package that we're using is the scanner. We're declaring and creating a scanner to obtain user input from the user keyboard. So here we've got system.out.print. This is your scanner up here that we're creating new. The new keyword is also really important. That's going to look at the different creating a new object when you go through it. So for instance, you've got scanner input. I called it input. You can call it whatever you want, as long as you refer to it then as the same name throughout. So input, I'm getting my next integer that it's input, I'm getting the next double that's input, I'm getting the next integer, and I'm putting it into this memory called number one, number two double, number three int. It depends on your naming conventions. Naming conventions are really important. So in the last video, I had a little talk about how I named this number one. Usually it's better to name it something more meaningful, but for a small example like this, it's not too bad. Double, I've put double at the end of number two, so you can identify when you're reading the code later on that it's where it's used is down here as double. So, and here I've got int, and I can see that it's used here and here. So every time you highlight something, you can see that it's used in other places. We had a little talk then about the if statement that I've used here. So there's if number one equals equals number three int. So we had a little brief introduction to equality within Java programming. So we talked a little bit about declaring, assigning, and using. So this is the declaration. I've assigned it the next integer that's coming from the input, and I'm putting it in here, and then I'm using it down here, so you can see where it's being used when you highlight something. This is equality, so if these two are equal, then print out this, otherwise it doesn't do anything. And that's all we're going to cover today. So this is all the output that we used in the last, and that's just a brief summary. So you can also do different operations here, mathematical operations within your if statement, which we'll get to in the next video. Okay, thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel, and we'll take it from there for the next, which is going to be chapter 3 of the Dotland title book, How to Programming Java. Okay, thank you.